for the NEC Versa M75. You see right here, I just took a screw out because the floppy drive was making a horrible noise when I tried to fix it. So let's go ahead and pop this thing open real quick and see what the heck went wrong. I cleaned the seek head of the head assembly. The track zero sensor, and it's a reflow a couple of spots as well because they were bad. Now it's not even working. So I'm gonna figure out what the next moment is making it. It's like it was so unbearable for me to hear it. Right now, I'm just disassembling the floppy drive again. I was going to post a YouTube video about it, but I figured I might as well just be only a live stream and delete the other videos off of my phone. And then I have that much space left on there. In any event, let's take a look at it and see what went wrong. What the heck went wrong here? Okay, so I'm not sure if you guys are able to see that or not, but there's the solder spot that I had to fix. Well, try to fix, excuse me. Attempted to fix, more likely. So I'm going to take this upstairs to my lab again and re-solder it. Go ahead and take this thing upstairs to my lab so I can do some more repairs on it. Sorry for if you guys are seeing the ceiling here. My tripod just wanted to act funny. So I gotta fix that real quick. There we go. Let's go ahead and set this over here. My faithful soldering iron. So I may left the screwdriver downstairs again. I have another one somewhere, but I can't remember where the heck I put it now. It was a good one. So in any event, let's go ahead and start the repair here. Let's do this without the floppy. Thank you. Alright, so I decided to find my other screwdriver. I decided I have a green one somewhere, but apparently they had decided to go up and mysteriously disappear. I always hate SMD components anyways. It's a pain in the arse to solder on. Oh jeez. Lord almighty. Now if I can get the... There we go. Sorry for me to do this and talk at the same time. I dropped the little order. Let me keep this open. There it is. Jesus Christ. Floppy. Time to bring you guys back downstairs. Reassemble this thing at home. Put my phone on the ceiling right on there. Back together. Get this time. Right, get back on here. Mm-hmm. Sorry, this is doing the tripod. Can you turn it over? I'm just going to hand test it again. It's going to quote charge, but it ain't. I'll put it up closer here so you guys can hear it flashing light over me. See if refolding that fixed it or. Well, you're gonna Floppy Drive fail this time. I guess I'm making that gurgling noise. It's right there. Hey, oops. Hello. Copy loadings I've hit for many years. Let's go ahead and try that real quick. Okay, read 720K disk without a problem, but the 1.4 megabyte disk is not really. So yeah, the drive is totally gone. I only read 720K disk, but not the whole 9 yards. Let's see. Me. Hi. See if it actually opens the program. And if it fails. Then the heart, then I flight, yep. That is toast. Here's the disk spray is doing. Thank you. Okay, so apparently this drive is totally gone. Does it want to read? Well, it does read some distance, but not all. And it's time for me to let the dogs out. So there's that for now. So I gotta go source the floppy drive for this Versa M75 notebook. So I'd like to use a CD drive on this laptop, but in order for me to do so, I have to take the hard drive out and put it into another laptop, and I'm too lazy to do that. So yeah, it looks like I have to source the floppy drive for this thing. Let's see where the hard drive is on this thing. See if there was all the hard drive is on this thing so I can pull it out. So here's the hard drive. That's 140 megabytes worth. On the plus side, it boots. From the hard drive, and negative side, there's no floppy drive. That's pretty safe. I'm gonna say it is what it is, but I don't think that'll be good for you to do. So, till next time. And see you soon. And, like I said, I just wish I can find another floppy. I have to source a floppy jar for this stinky thing that's working. As, these 46 laptops are 10 are known to have failing floppy drives. So I think the alignment's off, but I'm not good at realigning 3.5-inch floppy drives, or 5.25-inch drives for that matter. I know the timing has to be perfect and everything, the timing sound was correct and everything on here. Unfortunately, it just doesn't want to cut it. So, unfortunately, I have to source and perks for this thing. There's only the floppy drive. Hard drive is working fine. Anyway, till next time, thank you very much for watching.